This is the Southern West Virginia Community Band. This is our Christmas concert. That was Rudolph's Christmas Party. Three tunes written and performed by Johnny Marks. Obviously, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree, and A Holly Jolly Christmas. Our next number, The Bells of Christmas, is a mashup of three familiar Christmas tunes. Jingle Bells, one of the best-known and most commonly sung American songs in the world. It's written in 1850 by James Lord Pierpont. Carol the Bells, music from Mykolta Leonish, Ukrainian song, Shedrick, and lyrics by Peter Wilhowski. Leondrick wrote Shedrick in 1914, and in 1936, Wilhowski wrote the English lyrics. Silver Bells, a Christmas song composed by Jay Livingston and Ray Evans. The first recorded version was sung by Bing Crosby and Carol Richards, recorded on September 8, 1950, with John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, along with the Lee Gordon Singers. This is The Bells of Christmas.
Thank you. I
Yeah, that was a medley of Christmas tunes called The Lighter Side of Christmas. It consists of Frosty the Snowman, obviously a popular Christmas song, written by Walter Rollins and Steve Nelson, first recorded by Gene Autry and the Cass County Boys in 1950, and later recorded by Jimmy Durante the same year. Susie Snowflakes, a song written by Sid Tepper and Roy Bennett, made famous by Rosemary Clooney in 1951. C-H-R-I-S-T-M-A-S spells Christmas, written by Eddie Arnold, Jenny Lou Carson, performed by Rosemary Clooney. And Jingle Bell Rock, first released by Bobby Helms in 1957. It was composed by Joe Beal and James Booth. The last tune in that medley was The Christmas Polka, written by Paul Webster and Sonny Burke, famously recorded by Jim Reeves and also by the Andrews Sisters. The next tune is The First Noel. In Cornish origin, First Noel, its current form, was first published in Carol Ancient and Modern, 1823, and Gilbert and Sandy's Carols, 1833.
Thank you.
Okay, that was Fairy Tale of New York. That's a song written by Jim Finer and Shane McGowan, recorded by their London-based band, The Pogues, featuring English singer-songwriter Christy McCall on vocals. The song is an Irish folk-style ballad and was written as a duet, with The Pogues singer McGowan taking the role as the male character, McCall taking the female character. It was originally released as a single on the 23rd of November of 1987, and later featured on The Pogues' 1988 album, If I Should Fall from Grace with God. In the UK, Fairy Tale of New York is the most played non-carol Christmas song of the 21st century. Okay, the next tune, Christmas Time with Charlie Brown. It was the eighth studio album by American jazz pianist Vince Guaraldi, the Vince Guaraldi Trio, with bassist Fred Marshall and Jerry Grinnelli on drums. The album was released in December of 65. It is the soundtrack to the Christmas television special of the same name. Guaraldi was contracted by the television producer Lee Mendelson to compose music for a documentary on the comic strip Peanuts and Charles Schulz. Although the special went unaired, these selections were released in 1964 as Jazz Impressions of a Boy Named Charlie Brown. Coca-Cola commissioned the Christmas special based on Peanuts in 1965, and Guaraldi turned these tunes into the score. He composed most of the music, though he did include some versions of traditional carols like O Tannenbaum. It was voted to the Grammy Hall of Fame and added to the National Recording Registry by the Library of Congress. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, that was Do You Hear What I Hear, written in October of 62. Lyrics by Noel Regney and music by Gloria Shane. The pair were married at the time and wrote it as a plea for peace during the Cuban Missile Crisis. Regney had been invited by the record producer to write a Christmas song, but he was hesitant due to the commercialization of Christmas. Ironically, it sold tens of millions of copies and been covered by hundreds of artists. So he didn't get what he wanted. Do you hear What I Hear was released shortly after Thanksgiving in 62. The song was originally recorded for Mercury Records by the Harry Simone Chorale, a group that had also popularized the Little Drummer Boy. Bing Crosby made it a song into a hit when he recorded his own version in October of 63. Our next number is The Polar Express. The Polar Express is a 1985 fantasy children's book written and illustrated by American author Chris Allsburg. The book is now widely considered to be a classic Christmas story for young children. It was adapted into a 2004 American computer animated film. Written, produced, and directed by Robert Zemeckis, the film features human characters animated using the live-action performance capture technique. The soundtrack album was certified gold by the RIAA in November of 2007, having sold 724,000 copies in the U.S. It's the best-selling film soundtrack holiday album since SoundScan has been tracking music since 91. The song Believe, written by Glenn Ballard and Alan Silvestri, was nominated for Best Original Score at the 77th Academy Awards. It was sung at the 77th Academy Awards show by the original performer Josh, along with Beyoncé. It gained a Grammy in 2006.
Thank you.
Hallelujah is a song written by Canadian singer Leonard Cohen, originally released on his album Various Positions in 1984. It did not receive much success early on, but became popular when a new version was recorded by John Cale in 91. Cale's version inspired a 94 recording by Jeff Buckley that in 2004 was ranked number 259 on Rolling Stone's 500 Greatest Songs of All Time. The song achieved widespread popularity after Cale's version of it was featured in the 2001 film Shrek. Many other arrangements have been performed in recordings and concert with more than 300 versions known as of 2008. The song has been used in film and television soundtracks and televised talent contests. Hallelujah experienced renewed interest following Cohen's death in November of 2016 and reappeared on the International Singles Chart, including entering the American Billboard Hot 100 for the first time. Our next number, Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas, is a song written in 1943 by Hugh Martin and Ralph Blaine and introduced by Judy Garland in the 1944 MGM musical Meet Me in St. Louis. In 2007, ASCAP ranked it the third most performed Christmas song during the previous 5 years. In 2004, it finished at number 76 in American Film Institute's 100 Years, 100 Song rankings of the top tunes of American cinema. Thank you. Thank you very much. This is our last tune. Sleigh Ride. It's a... Okay, Sleigh Ride's a light orchestra standard composed by Leroy Anderson. The composer had formed the original idea for the piece during the heat wave of July 1946, and he finished the work in February of 48. Its first performance was by the Boston Pops, Arthur Fiedler conducting on June 7, 1948. The original recordings were instrumental versions. The lyrics about riding in a sleigh and other wintertime activities were written by Mitchell Parrish in 1950. Anderson's own version reached the charts when re-released in 1952. The Ronettes version charts every single year on Billboard's Hot 100 Holiday Songs. Thank you. That's the only encore we have, so.